You're running out of time to beat Election Day headaches in the coming elections. Early voting in Canyon and Ada County wraps up tomorrow. Voters can head to the Canyon County Elections Office until Friday, November 1st. In Ada County, four locations are available. That includes Boise and Meridian City Halls and the Ada County Elections Office.
One of the great benefits of early voting is that anyone from anywhere in Ada County can come to any of these locations and vote. So, for example, if you live in Meridian but you're working in downtown Boise, stop in at Boise City Hall. We print each individual voter's ballot right there on demand, and that way you can ensure you get the right contents to vote on no matter where you live.
Turnout has been high. The election office credits the larger than average early voting numbers to numerous mayoral and city council races and the Boise Library and Stadium initiatives. Again, Election Day is next Tuesday, November 5th. He made claims of killing over 40 people, and he's been sitting on death row in Idaho for nearly 40 years for the murder of one. Thomas Creech is convicted of the murder of a fellow inmate back in 1981. But what many people don't know about Thomas Creech is that murder of his fellow inmate wasn't his only murder. And it wasn't the only time Creech was sentenced to death row.
We were able to tie together other murders that he committed and eventually got admissions from him with regard to the vast majority of the murders that he committed, which we finally determined, at least based on our best efforts to determine the number, became 27 murders, even though Creech at one time admitted to 40.
Tomorrow at 10 o'clock on Six on Your Side, we'll tell you the history of Thomas Creech, the Idaho inmate who has been housed on death row the longest, and will attempt to uncover the cost to taxpayers when it comes to representation, prosecution, and housing a death row inmate.
Now, Chief Meteorologist Scott Dorval with the On Your Side forecast.
Another frigid morning across the valley today and all across the region. Temperatures single digits in many places in the valley. We were in the teens. Tomorrow we'll probably go to the upper teens to near 20. Did get up to 43 though today in Boise. And tomorrow, not much warmer than this. It's just slowly we warm things up just a little bit, mostly from the west and north. Up in Riggins, for instance, we could hit 55 for a high temperature during the day tomorrow. And the cloud cover we had today, that's streaming south and east. Even some snow showers near Idaho Falls are streaming south and east. This little mass of clouds that's been dimming our sunshine, making the sky murky, will disappear. And a lot of blue skies, dry weather up here. This is what's going to be pushing on in to Idaho, and that will keep us clear. Notice how the warm weather has been working its way around this ridge of high pressure. This whole thing's going to slide to the east, and the result is some slightly milder weather will move in. And we'll actually see it first in the higher elevations. Stanley, during the late afternoon, was just as warm as Boise was today because of the mild air streaming in those higher elevations. So here's the result. Tomorrow, 48 degrees in Boise after 22 in the morning, 25 Saturday, 27 Sunday, getting above or close to above freezing or close to freezing, I should say, the middle part of next week, early part of next week. We change our clocks this weekend, and the weekend, it looks to be sunny, mostly sunny, even on Sunday, with temperatures maybe getting into the low 50s. So not a terrible weekend, and these will be seasonable temperatures coming in next Monday and Tuesday. I'll have another update right here later today.